Michigan is making their first appearance in the conference finals. However, in 2011, they were able to upset the championship-tested San Antonio Spurs in six games. First quarter, Tony Parker and those San Antonio Spurs in control. Parker looking and finding Danny Green out and alone for three. Green can fill it up from distance. He was 3 of 6 from range on the game. Later first quarter, Tony Parker. Don't double him. He's going to go all the way to the basket. He lays that one in. 9 of 14 from the field. Spurs up 18-6. Later, Gary Neal passing to Matt Bonner, who nails the three-pointer from outside. 2 of 2 on threes in the quarter. Spurs already up 29-12. Bonner this time returning the favor. Kicks it over to Gary Neal. Gary Neal, a quick drive to get inside the three-point line. He knocks that one down. He had 11 points on the day. San Antonio up 35-16. Later, Conley missing the floater. That's Mike Conley. The Spurs rebound and go the other way. Tony Parker on the run out gets to the basket and lays it in. He had a game-high 20 points. Things not going well for the Grizzlies on the other end. Trying to share the ball around, but Zach Randolph loses it out of bounds. He was 0 for 3 from the field in the first half. The Grizzlies had 7 first-half turnovers, but Marc Gasol did come to play. He had 12 in the first half. San Antonio's lead down to 12. Outside in the corner, that a beautiful shot from Kawhi Leonard, who was 6 of 13. The Spurs were 6 of 13 from downtown in the half. Third quarter, Marc Gasol passing it inside to Zach Randolph, who goes up with a couple tips. Can't get the shot to go down. We go the other way, and Tony Parker uses the screen to perfection, knocking down the jump shot. Zach Randolph finished just 1 of 8 on the game. The Spurs up by 16. Jared Bayless outside to Quincy Pondexter, who knocks down the three. Quincy Pondexter led Memphis in scoring with 17 points. Jared Bayless with the steal, and here comes Memphis. The Grizzlies on a 10-0 run. The Spurs lead down to 6, and yeah, Coach Popovich wants a timeout later in the third. How about the Red Rocket? Matt Bonner again for 3, 12 points off the bench in the game, all coming from three-point land. Later in the third, Manu Ginobili weaving his way to the basket. Tough layup there. The Spurs on an 11-1 run to end the quarter. Fourth quarter, they're just going deep. Kawhi Leonard burying a three-pointer. He had 18 points on the game. How about Gary Neal off the Danny Green dish? That works as well. Spurs up 87-65. Then Kawhi Leonard from the corner for three. The Spurs set a franchise record in the playoffs. 4 threes made with 14 of them. They were 14 of 29 from distance. San Antonio takes a 1-0 lead in the Western Conference Finals.
And then they shut him down to 89% in the last 4 games.
Parker with the left hand.
He's off and running, Mike. He feels it. He's accepting the challenge. And then in the open floor, he is going. Randolph are not getting clean looks off the dribble.
Diaw finds Green. Danny Green floats in, banks it in, and a foul. Green with a chance for a three-point play. Averaging double figures in the playoffs at 10 per game.
Well, this is what I like about his game. You have to guard him for the three because he shoots it over 40. And he plays the...
Member of that Portland Trailblazers championship team under the great Dr. Jack Ramsey. Parker down the lane. Nobody there to stop him. Poor transition defense from the Grizzlies.
Well, they were there, Mike, but no one intercepted the dribbler. The old story, make the man pass the basketball.
It out, open three, Leonard. Danny Green, the offensive board.
They right they had the guards down inside.
Parker throws a rifle pass, and Leonard able to finish. Tony Parker with another assist.
Okay, when that shot came out of the quarter, the big men were inverted. Consequently, the small guards were down inside, and Green just went right up over to receive that rebound.
Blair with the spin, flips it up and in. How about Blair with a couple of circus shots? They're in garbage time down the stretch. Blair is not playing as much as he used to earlier in his career, but Greg Popovich is proud of
him. He won a game, and they only have 4. That was their second offensive rebound.
Bonner, that's another three. Bonner's third three-pointer here in the first half. couple of years ago led the league in three-point percentage. And a big boost for San Antonio here in game one. Quick bucket there. Well, just over 2 minutes gone by. And 7-2 San Antonio.
Rebounding teams in the league would have a few. They have zero right now.
Barker back to Bonner. Extra pass. Neal pulls up. Two-pointer is good. Well, the bench has been excellent for San Antonio. The backup by 19.
Mike, the mid-range game is there. The three-point game.
Tony, Pop talked pregame about what a dangerous half-court execution and offensive rebounding team Memphis was. What pleased you about what you did defensively?
I think it was a great effort. The whole team played great defense. We did a good job on Zach, did a pretty good job on Mark, and I think that's the key to slow down Memphis.
Memphis came in very aware of your prowess from the three-point line. How do you guys generate consistently wide-open shots from this distance?
Ball movement was great tonight. Got great penetration from everybody, and we tried to take good shots. And even if you had a good shot, we did an extra pass. And so we shoot a good percentage. It helps, makes threes. It was good for game one, so now we'll see in game two.
For long stretches, Zach Randolph looked frustrated. How do your interior guys sustain what they did today?
Well, that's the key in the series. We have to stop them. And we did good in game one, but we know they're going to come back strong in game two. They're going to play very motivated with a lot of energy. And I know Zach, he's going to come back strong in game two.
You weren't bad yourself. Thanks, Tony.
All right, thank you.